There are separate complete hydrolysis, three plus the other products. Hydrolysis, same. Hydrolysis, same. We are getting water, Q, plus other products. What is Q? And how many gaseous products are generated? The 99 are most question. This is based on this. I already clearly taught you based on this particular equation, this particular question. I clearly given the details about this particular question and all. I clearly discussed in the class notes. Check it, you can either get it. Audit. Hello, Sicharan, are you getting any idea or not? Sicharan.
Sir,
are you getting any idea?
Sir, first reaction I know, sir.
Aslam, Muhammad Aslam, are you getting it, Mr. Aslam? Are you there in the class? Hey, Mr. Sir, Ramdai Aslam. Anitesh?
Sir, that's Javed, sir.
Sir, that is Javed, sir.
MD Teja, Paniteja, you are there?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting it? Got it?
No, sir.
Clearly given in the notes. This is, you know, exponent complete hypolysis. First one, you know, based on this only I made this particular question clearly given in the notes. You know, hexachloride, complete hydrolysis, 3H2O, this is vinyl O3 now, vinyl O3, 6HF, this is what P, P is what vinyl trioxide, and vinyl trioxide plus NaOH hydrolysis, we give you final product. The two-step hydrolysis is there. First and again second. Whatever it will be, final product is Q. Okay, around O3 plus NaOH. We give you what? NaH, around O4. This is what sodium zinate I said. Sodium zinate, see what was clearly there. Sodium zinate, partial hydrolysis. This won't stop here again. Any H is 0 and O4, See, it presents up again. Any which ultimate product. This is now any force 0 0 6. Any force 0 0 6. Any force 0 0 6. Come on, what do you need here? What are the other gases products? Come on. See your notes at least. Open your notes and see at least. Xenon O3, notes to see.
Xenon plus oxygen.
Xenon plus oxygen. Plus 2H2. So what is actually Q? This is Q. Final product. This is Q. Q is Na4. Xenon O6. What do you call it? Sodium zinate. Sodium zinate, this one. This is sodium perxenate. Sodium perxenate. And plus two gaseous products. Two gaseous products. Two gaseous products. The question 2019, right? Advance. Number of gaseous products. Two gaseous products. This is sodium zinate. In this, look here. Xenon oxidation number is plus 6. Xenon oxidation number is plus 6 in this. What is the oxidation number of xenon in this? What is perxenate? Perxenate. In this, xenon is plus 6. In this, xenon is what? Perxenate. Updated, shall I give you this? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Come on, I'm going to rectify this complete zero group questionnaire. Zero group element questionnaire we completed. Then, go to regular class, we completed ferromagnetic substance, ferromagnetic substance, and anti ferromagnetic substance. Now we have to do ferrimagnetic substance. Come on, ferrimagnetic substance. In some of the substances, the number of lines of magnetic moment vectors. In some of the substances, the number of lines of magnetic moment vectors working in the direction of the field of the magnet and working opposite to the field of the magnetic moment. The number of lines of magnetic moment working in the direction of the field of the magnet, working opposite to the field of the magnet, when this number is not same, such substance is with slightly paramagnetic property. Such substance is called ferrimagnetic substance. Look carefully. In some of the substances, the number of lines of magnetic moment vectors working in the direction of the field of the magnet, working opposite to the field of the magnet, if this particular number is not same, I written 2 and 1, then such substances exhibit slightly paramagnetic moment or paramagnetic property. Such substances are what you call ferrimagnetic substance. Best example under ferrimagnetic substance is Fe3O4, ferrous peroxide is the best example under this particular ferrimagnetic substance. Other examples, you can take other example. Ferrites of formalin. M plus two, Fe2O4. M plus two stands for, it may be magnesium, it may be nickel, it may be copper, it may be zinc, it may be copper, it may be zinc, is what all plus two. All plus two. What is that? This is Mg, suppose. This is Mg, Fe2O4. Mg, Fe2O4, or Ni, Fe2O4, Cu, Fe2O4, Zn, Fe2O4, coming under this particular examples, very magnetic substances. Very few compounds under this particular very magnetic substances. In some of the substances, the number of lines of magnetic moment vectors, working in the direction of the field of the magnet, and working opposite to the field of the magnet, and working opposite to the field of the magnet. If this number is not same, number is not same, that substance exhibit slightly paramagnetic property, such substance is known as ferrimagnetic substance. Examples. Example, Fe3O4, second one, ferrites of formulae, M plus 2 Fe2O4. Mg plus 2, Na plus 2, Cu plus 2, Zn plus 2, for example, right? The last point, right? After this. Updated?
Sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Come on. Representation of the last point. Representation of magnetic moment vectors in ferrimagnetic substance. The number is not equal. next, Curie temperature and Weyl temperature. Look here, you take any paramagnetic substance, any magnetic substance. You are heating the magnetic substance or beating the magnetic substance, either heat or beat. It is losing its magnetic property in no well. Take the magnet and hammer it, it is losing its magnetic property. Take the magnet, go on heat it, it is losing its magnetic property. Or if you are heating to a particular temperature, one property may be changing into another property. One property may be changing into another property. These things will happen. Based on this particular, two temperatures are established. One is Curie temperature, second one is what? Weyl temperature. What is Curie temperature? What is Weyl temperature? See the board. So, take a ferromagnetic substance. What I'm saying? Ferro. Take a ferromagnetic substance, go on heat. Go on heat. At particular temperature, at particular temperature, the ferromagnetic substance simply converts into paramagnetic. Simply converts into paramagnetic. Such substance is what we call Curie temperature. Such temperature what we call Curie temperature. Ferro to para, the temperature got Curie. Next are Weyl temperature. Weyl temperature. Take antiferro substance. Take antiferro substance, bond heater. At particular temperature, bond heater. At particular temperature, this antiferro change into para substance. Antiferro change into para substance. This particular temperature what we call Weyl temperature. Ferro to para, Curie. Antiferro to para, Weyl temperature. Right, so much is there to discuss, we'll discuss it. Come on, as it is today. As it is today, Curie temperature, Weyl temperature, just to remember this. Enough. Okay, completed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See the board. Okay. Total paramagnetic moment. Total paramagnetic moment of any substance equal to the word spin angular moment plus orbital angular moment. Spin angular moment plus orbital angular moment. A particular substance is exhibiting certain magnetic property that depend on two factors. One is spin angular moment. Second one is what? Orbital angular moment. You know what is spin angular moment and orbital angular moment? This can be given by equation. S plus L. S stands for spin angular moment, L stands for orbital angular moment, S plus L is equal to under root of 4S, under root of 4S into S plus 1 plus L into L plus 1. 4S into S plus 1 plus L into L plus 1. This is spin angular moment, this is what orbital angular moment. Spin and orbital angular moment. Orbital angular moment. Next. What is spin angular moment and orbital angular moment? See this, you are not following it. The electron is actually revolving around the nucleus. Electron is revolving around the nucleus, yes. While it is revolving, it is spinning on its own axis. It is spinning on its own axis and again revolving around the nucleus in a particular orbit. Once it is spinning on its own axis, developing a magnetic moment, what is called spin angular moment. Once it is revolving around the nucleus in a particular orbit, developing one more magnetic moment, that what we call the orbital angular moment. Therefore, once electron is actually moving, developing two magnetic moments. One is spin angular moment, second one is what? Orbital angular moment. So, including both of these together, we call it as total paramagnetic moment. This can be given by the equation nu S plus L equal to under root of 4S into S plus 1 plus L into L plus 1. This is the equation. Come on, next to see. In D-block elements, especially in 3D series, the orbital angular moment is quenched. The orbital angular moment is quenched by the ligand fields. pentodiene, the ligand fix. In the case of D block elements, especially 3D series, the orbital angular mobility is cancelled by the ligand fix. Why? Because d orbitals are there in the penultimate shell near to the ligand fix. D orbitals are there in the penultimate shell near to the ligand fix. You are not following. Clearly, come to the point. So, in the case of D, 1, 3D, 1, 2, 3, 4. 3D means fourth, again, fourth shell, I said. This is what? 4S2. This is what? 3D. Here, ligand. This is the ligand. This is the ligand. This is what? 3D orbital. Ligand and 3D orbital. So, this orbital angular moment of the electron is cancelled or influenced by the ligand fix, because this particular ligands are there in the penetrating shell near to the ligands. This particular d orbitals in the penetrating shell near to the ligand fix. These are actually very near. Therefore, the ligand fix is affecting the orbital angular moment of electron in the d orbitals. Therefore, we need not consider this particular orbital angular moment. Are you getting the point or not? Following all? Are you followed or not? The orbital angular moment,
yes, sir,
in the case of D block elements, especially in 3D series, is negligible because it is affected by the ligands. Affected by the ligands because the orbitals are there in the penultimate shell near to the ligands. Near to the ligands. Therefore, it is influenced, therefore, getting cancer. Therefore, total paramagnetic moment only dependent on spin angular moment, only dependent on spin angular moment or number of unpaired electrons, only spin angular moment or number of unpaired electrons. It can be calculated by half of the equation. Do yes, plus yes. Wait for 5 minutes, Mr. Vincent. Wait for 2 minutes. Thank you. right? Total barometric moment, spin angular moment plus circle angular moment is the equation. But in the case of D-block element, especially in 3D series, the orbital angular moment is quenched by the like hand fields because d orbital also there in the penalty mixture, near to the like hands. Therefore, like hand energy there on d orbital orbital angular moment. Therefore, it is negligible, it need not be considered. Therefore, in D block element, especially in 3D series, the total magnetic moment depends on number of unpaired electrons or only spin angular moment. Only spin angular moment. This can be calculated by half of the equation. Second half is not required. Only half equation is sufficient. Therefore, it can be calculated by this particular rho s plus l equal to under root of 4s into s plus 1 or another equation this rho s plus l or rho effective is also equal to rho effective let us say instead of saying this of rho effective rho effective rho effective under root of 4s into s plus 1 or there is one more equation under root of n into n plus 2 n into n plus 1 n into n plus 1 n into n plus 1. Now either you use this particular equation can also be written as 2 into under root of n by 2 into n by 2 plus 1. Then one more equation is you can also rho effective is also equal to one more equation g into under root of s into s plus 1. Now whether you use this equation or this equation or this equation or this equation, value will be same. By using all either of the equation, for one electron you get 1.7, for two electrons you get 2.8, so value will be same either of the equation you can write. Don't confuse. Wherever spin you use, then yes sir, you want to use the spin and calculate, take yes sir. Wherever you want to use the number of unpaired electrons, use n. N stands for number of unpaired electrons. S stands for spin. Suppose one unpaired electron is there. Suppose at the base of n, use 1. Suppose want to use S, 4 into half. 4 into half. For one electron, S stands for half, N stands for 1. Either you use this, or this. Either of the equation give the same value for a particular number of electron. Here, what is G? G stands for number gyromagnetic ratio. Gyromagnetic ratio, its value is 1.99, roughly you can take 2. This was right. So much in there, there is no place in the board. Right now, as it is, come on. Total paramagnetic moment equal to spin angular moment. Full words were all right like that. Whatever is that? Complete word. Spin angular moment. Orbital angular moment. Full wording you write, don't write the symbols like that. Spin angular moment plus orbital angular moment. In D block elements, especially in 3D series, the orbital angular moment is quenched by the like hand fields. Because d orbitals are there in the penultimate shell. D orbitals are there in the penultimate shell. Penultimate, sir. Penultimate, sir. Near to the line and fix. Near to the line and fix. Therefore, total magnetic moment depend on number of unpaired electrons, or spin angular moment. Spin angular moment. It can be calibrated by U effective equal to under root of 4s into s plus 1 right hand of it.
Sir, there in second equation, there you are 2 into root of n by 2 into n by 2 plus 1, sir. It's not equal to n into n plus 1.
N plus 2, sir.
But
are not equal?
No, sir.
N plus 1. Equal?
Yes, sir. Okay. Not equal.
Would n plus 2 equal then?
Yes, sir. If you write n plus 2, then it will be equal.
N plus 2. Okay, now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Take G. G stands for diagrammatic ratio. Its value is 2. X value is 2. Where am I ratio? Its value is 2. Next right. See, if you know, then you know this. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Look here. If you know the number of unpaired electrons, you know the number of unpaired electrons in a metal or the compound, you can easily say its magnetic moment. Roughly, come on, make a table. Number of unpaired electrons. Number of unpaired electrons. Spin magnetic moment. One, two, three, four, five, half. 1.5, 2.5. Spin. Magnetic moment. Four magnetons here. 2.823, four magnetons. 3.83 to 4. 4 microtons. 4.87 to 5, 4 microtons. 5.9 to 6, more magnetons. This way. Take it. So you completed.
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. What do you observe? What do you follow from this? Generally, when you know the unpaired electrogenic element of the compound, then roughly say the magnetic moment. Roughly, you can say the magnetic moment. See, roughly 1.82, for example, I do. 1.8, 2.8, 3.8, 4.8, 5.8. Like that, but you know the number of unpaired electrons, you can easily hit the magnetic moment. The number of unpaired electrons add plus 0.8. So that 1.8, 2.8, 3.8, 4.8, 5.8, roughly you can see the magnetic moment. Next, the units for magnetic moment, the magnetic moment is 4 magnetons, remember. 4 magnetons, BMs. What BM is going to remember, EH by 4πmc, EH by 4πmc, no, E stands for electronic charge, H Planck's constant, M mass of electron, C velocity of light, C velocity of light, C velocity of light. Next up, look here, 1bm, 1bm is equal to 9.273 into 10 to the power of minus 24 joules per Tesla. Joules per Tesla. And similarly, what we have is also equal to 2.9273 into 10 to the power of minus 21 X for gas. X for gas. These are the limits for this particular magnetic moment. Right on. 1 BM equal to, and what is the value saying? Joules per Tesla. X per gas, as it is, come on.
Sir, that is 10 power minus 21, sir.
Okay. The magnetic moment is generally measured by using a balance. What do you call current balance? We use over balance. The instrument used to measure the magnetic balance. Suppose you are prepared a new compound. You are doing a research about a new compound. It is paramagnetic or diamond, you don't know. You want to know whether it is para or dia, how many unpaired electrons are there in this, then you have to choose the instrument. The instrument name is called Guy Barrens. Guy Barrens is like this. Generally, this will be the Barrens. Two big magnetic poles are there, one a north pole, one a south pole. In between these two magnetic poles, they are actually hanging a glass tube. It is connected to a digital weighing machine. For example, you are prepared some XY compound. This particular compound is taken into this particular dye barrens. How much you take, for example, 1 milligram. 1 milligram of substance is taken into that. And you put on the instrument. Suppose if weight is increased by 1.5, so 1 milligram you are taken. After putting on the instrument, its weight is increased to 1.5 milligram. What do you understand? Para dia. Parada, come on. Its weight is increasing. Parada. Huh?
Understand by using an equation.
How many number of unpaid electrons are there? I'll give few questions on that. What are appeared last year and before last year in the entrance exam? Come on, take it. The instrument you use, to measure the magnetic moment is Guy Barrett's. Guy Barrett's. Next. In the magnetic field, the paramagnetic substance shows. A paramagnetic substance shows a greater weight than its net weight. But a damaged substance shows. Lesser weight than its net weight in the magnetic field. Next, to calibrate this particular guy bearings, calibration. Do you know calibration? The English word calibration. Calibration means the instrument is used by you, me, and somebody in the laboratory. Right? Then often the instrument is disturbed. It may not be proper. Then we have to make it to zero. No, we have to make it to zero and we have to do the experiment. X is done, some disturbance is there. Then Y is going to go on the substance. That one, we have to calibrate whether it is correctly working or not. To correct this particular balance, that word calibration. Calibration, the calibration of this particular guy bearing, the compound generally applied for HG. CMO, NCS, they can four times. This is a compound that will use to calibrate data. Okay, To calibrate guy bearings, the compound you raise, HG, CMO, NCS, taken for. HGCO NCS taken form. NCS taken form. Next. How the questions appear in the exam? Read out. For a particular substance, the magnetic moment is 36 into 10 to the power of minus 24 joules per Tesla. What will be number of unpaired electrons in that particular compound. compound.
3, sir.
Good answer.
3.
3. 3. How? 3. How you calculate it?
Hey, how you calculate it, Bishop? Sir, divided four, by that one Bohr magnet and we get number of 100.
Okay. 9.273 into 10 to the power of minus 24 joules per Tesla equal to 1 mm. Okay. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then 36 equal to how much? How much?
4, sir.
Then how many electrons?
3.
Electrons? No. 4 BM. 4 BM means 3.8 or 4. Next question. Good. Well done. Next question. All of you follow this question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Good. Next one. In a particular compound of cobalt, compound of cobalt, the magnetic moment is 5 BM. The magnetic moment is 5 BM. And what will be oxidation number of cobalt? Oxidation number of the cobalt in the compound. Cobalt in the compound.
Sir, maximum, sir. You are asking maximum, sir.
What maximum?
Oxidation state.
Huh? You are given a particular cobalt compound, the magnetic moment you found by putting the balance into the balance, that is showing what? 5 BM. Okay? 5 BM.
Yes, sir.
5 BM. Then what will be the oxidation number of the cobalt in that compound?
Sir, all?
Eppudu all unte all cheptara ayyadu meeru. Ippudu ekkada all unte all cheppesanu meeru answer.
Plus
four. Wherever I am keeping the all, you simply are saying all. Huh?
No, sir. No,
okay,
sir.
Mr. Look here. 5 BM is the magnetic moment. How many unpaired electrons?
4, sir.
4. Then you have to check it. In which oxidation number, cobalt is carrying 4 unpaired electrons? Kalkal equally yes, sir. In which oxidation number, cobalt is carrying 4 unpaired electrons? You have to check on the paper. Then you have to say the answer.
Plus 4, sir.
Go for cobalt plus 3, go for cobalt plus 4. Then without doing on the paper, the gali kotta podi inge emu akkada eppudu gaani chuda gaani then idu gali lo idu imagine chesi cheppinante poyinatte adi d7a0 how many entry 3 cobalt plus 3 d6a0 how many entry 4 plus 4, D5S0, I mean N5, like this, you have to put on the paper and check. Then what is the answer now?
Plus 4.
Huh?
Plus 3, sir.
Plus 3. This is the way to do. That a gali ki imagine jesu, utane gali kepte, andar ko sara, in the house tell you. Nei rojji paan ke paan akare le indigo. You can also get easily directly into IIT and IIT Madras now. బాంబే లో కూడా ఐటీ వచ్చేస్తుంది అంత ఈజీగా అందరి క్వశ్చన్ వచ్చేస్తాయి. నెక్స్ట్ ఇన్ కంపౌండ్ ఆఫ్ ఐరన్ కమాన్ ఆన్సర్ ఇస్ కోబాల్ట్ ప్లస్ 3. అది ఏం రాసిందో రాసుకోండి, మీరు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు వెంటనే రాసుకోవాలి. మీరు మళ్ళీ మీరు ఓపెన్ చేస్తుంది మీకు రాదని. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Right. Take next question. Same type of question I am giving. In a compound of iron, in a compound of iron, the magnetic moment is 6 PM. The magnetic moment is 6 PM. What will be oxidation number of iron in the compound? Iron in the compound. Take the answers. Question attend yes ko. Into question attend yes ko ani. Any unpaired electron will come through ani. Any oxidation number unpaired electrons will choose ko ani. Put on the paper and check. Put the garlic jappu. All under all answer jappu. Right.
Sir, plus 3 sir.
What?
Plus 3 sir.
Madam sir, plus 2 or plus 4?
Plus 3 sir.
26, D6S2, Fe, precipitin D5, D5 will 5 electron, 6, therefore answer got B. This is the way to do. This is one. Tomorrow we will continue on this. This particular magnetic properties, the questions, and different concepts. The complete right. Tomorrow we will continue.
Sir, paper doubts.
Yeah, paper doubts. Any doubts? Sir, who? A paper. 23rd paper. 21st paper. Any paper?
Sir, 48.
ఇందులో 48 అంటే మరి క్వశ్చన్ ఏంటి 48 అంటే
సార్ టెస్ట్ నెంబర్ 48 సార్
టెస్ట్ నెంబర్
48 సార్ 48
48 లో క్వశ్చన్ ఓకే గుడ్
ఫస్ట్ వన్ సార్
సల్ఫర్ రిగార్డ్ ఇన్ ఓనియం ద డీప్ బ్లూ సొల్యూషన్ కంటైనింగ్ పాలియోడోమిక్ సల్ఫర్ కేటయాన్ ఇస్ ఆక్సైడ్ ద ఫార్ములా ఆఫ్ ద కేటయాన్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇస్ I given now. Answer is B. I given this is you break my question again. Has the correct given or not? When sulfur is dissolved in ammonium, deep blue solution contains the polyatomic sulfur. Cation is obtained. That is. Deep blue solution containing polyatomic sulfur cation is obtained. That is Si plus 2. Given? This is the question I have given this question in your notes. Next. Only question is not only. Next.
Sir, second.
Second question, sir.
Second question. What is it? Solution obtained by passing hydrogen sulfide gas through saturated aqueous solution of sulfur dioxide. Recknotes solution, Torrance reagent, photographer's fixer, oil of vitriol. Answer is B. Answer is what? A only. This I did not cover in the class. This is nothing but colloidal sulfur. The sulfur solution carrying colloidal sulfur. Okay, H2S passed into S4 to aqueous solution getting sulfur precipitate. And precipitate what you call? Colloidal sulfur. Solution of sulfur, colloidal sulfur, then what you call? It is Wecken. Roder's solution, right. This is new to you. To me also, you know. Yes, sir, remember. Yes, I agree. I did not cover this point to you. Absolutely. Good. Next.
Sir, 21st, sir.
21st. Okay, 21st. Okay, 21st question.
Sir, 21st question, sir. SS bonds in H2O7.
Okay, 21st question paper. Leader,
na? Yes, sir.
Na 48, na?
Na 48 lo na, sir. 21st.
Adhe 21st ka numbering where undi?
How many SS bonds are there in H2O7?
How many SS bonds?
Integer type, sir.
Integer. How many SS bonds are there in H2O7-2? Zero, wala?
Sir, he gave it, sir.
Huh?
Gave 8.
8.
0 అదే అంటే రాసేటప్పుడు అట్లా అయిందా 0 కదా ఎస్ఎస్ బాండ్ లేదు అందులో
Yes, sir. Zero.
Right. Zero. Okay, I agree with you. Zero.
Sir, ninth question, sir.
Zero.
Okay. Sir.
Okay, okay. Zero. Ah, next.
Sir, ninth, sir.
Huh?
Nine.
The acid having a S double bond S bond and a lone pair on S atom is.
Okay, paper 48 test, 47 test.
48 only, sir.
48 question and jump.
Ninth.
Ninth answer. Acid having S double bond, S,
huh? Ah, yes, sir.
S, 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 S select the incorrect statement among the following.
Yes, sir.
This is not hydrolyzed because SL bond strength is very high. SL bond is mainly saturated. SF6 is non-pore molecule. SF6 has tetrahedral strength. That is not correct. B is not correct. SF bond strength is very high. S is coordinated saturated. SF6 is non-polar molecule. SF bond strength. Okay, you take SF bond strength.
But
bond strength is very strong. Therefore, it cannot be easily hydrolyzed. Really, any compound not undergoing hydrolysis, bond strength is high. Next.
SF6 does not have a tetrahedral structure, no, sir.
Sir is asking incorrect statement, sir.
Sir is asking incorrect, sir.
B only, right?
B only.
The number of SEO, SE bonds in there is 4. 4. Which answer? 4A? 4A,
sir.
Correct.
Yes, sir. Sir, question number 20. 20, sir.
20, yeah. SO is more powerful reducing agent. Basic video. It's already carrying lone pairs. It is actually a base. Base strongly acts in basic video model. Therefore, answer is B. Correct or?
Okay, sir.
Antena?
Okay, sir.
Any more? Okay.
That's it, sir.
Right. You come here?
No, sir.
No, sir.
That's enough? Any more, any paper?
No, sir. That's it, sir.